Hey guys, how's it going? DUJ2 here, and welcome back to Fortnite Save the World, and welcome to a developer update video that we received earlier today. So we're going to talk about this. If you haven't seen it yet, I recommend you go check it out. This is the tweet. I will, of course, leave the link down below for both the tweet and the video on YouTube that you can go check out. This is a different one, guys. This is definitely a different one. We're going to go through it a little bit. I don't watch videos on stream like this. And the reason why I don't do it is because I don't really have... I like getting the content creator's permission to react to a video. And in this case, I don't have Fortnite's permission to watch the whole video on here. But we will break it down a little bit. So if you guys want to pause this video on and go watch the video right now, definitely go do it. Go watch the whole thing. It's very interesting what they're talking about, but if you want to come back after, we can talk about and break it down a little bit more. So what they talked about in it is going to be three things. So they talked about Canny Valley Act 3, down tier crafting, and Frost Knight. Canny Valley Act 3 actually is coming in version 7.0, which is incredibly fast considering that we just got part 2 a couple of weeks ago. So that is extremely fast. Down tier crafting, it basically means that if you have, let's say you by mistake took a weapon up to Shadow Shard or Obsidian, and you're like, oh, I'm still in Canny Valley, I can't really go through and I can't make a lot of, you know, I don't have a lot of Shadow Shard, and I want to go back to making Malachite weapons, well, don't be afraid. You'll actually be able to select making it at a lower star. So making 3-star, 4-star, 5-star materials, weapons and schematics, even if they are already at 5-stars, which is amazing. And Frost Knight is going to be the winter event. So Frost Knight is going to be the winter event that's going to be coming in a couple of weeks. Now, again, like I said, if you want to go watch what they showed, because they have some really good graphics and some in-game playing, gameplay, you can actually like go check it out, guys. You know, take a look at it. It's really interesting what they're talking about. But what I want to do right now is I want to go through and I want to talk about in depth about this, because there were several things in this video that kind of really struck out at me. So the first thing I want to talk about is the Canny Valley Part 3. So 7.0 Canny Valley Part 3. First off, I want to say I'm kind of surprised, and I'm sure a lot of us are, that we are getting part 3 so soon. And I think what happened here is I'm not saying we weren't supposed to get it right now. I think we were supposed to get part 3 at version 7. And if you guys remember way back when we got part 1, I did say I think what's going to happen is that every single new version we're going to get a new part. But what happened in version 6 is I don't know if they got caught up making the new UI improvements. I don't know if there was a delay somehow or something else happened. I kind of think that because of the craziness of the summer schedule for Battle Royale, of course Epic Games owns both games, both versions of the game, I honestly believe that Battle Royale came to take precedent in importance or in priority in development. Now this is not a bad thing. This is not a bad thing. This just basically means that when they were deciding to develop, you know, what to develop and what to focus on, they just focused on Battle Royale a little bit more. Whether that be the case or something else, who knows? I think that we were supposed to get part 2 at the beginning of version 6 and then part 3 and version 7 at the beginning. So every single version, I think we're going to get a big chunk of story, a new story, part of the storyline. But that's not the important thing. The very important thing is what they say. It's actually incredibly, incredibly interesting what they say in the Canny Valley Part 3. So in the video, they say that Canny Valley Part 3 is part of the Stand and Fight campaign. So the stand-in fight campaign, and we didn't know about that. I mean, maybe it kind of sounds a little familiar to me. Maybe that it's been talked about in the past. But the stand-in fight campaign basically means that it started when we first activated a home base and ends in a final decisive battle against the storm. Those are the exact words they used. And I think that is incredibly interesting. So this means that, and they went on to say, or the guy who, Nick, the guy who was in, you know, doing the video, went on to say, Fortnite is not a story about survival. It's a story about building a better world. So this kind of comes back into play into, it fills in a few little gaps of what exactly we're doing in this game. Because I still have on the back burner several videos that I'm working on of Fortnite Save the World lore and just the story where we're coming from here and kind of like my perspective of what is this game. Because all we know is that we're fighting husks in a world with blue glow and purple storms where most of the people have been turned into husks, and we're building stuff and trying to survive. But apparently this kind of comes to show that this is a, oh, and also don't forget, this is a world where glass does not exist and bacon is found in toilets, okay, and doghouses, very important. So it's very interesting to see that we're kind of starting to get more of a rounded out concept and idea of what Save the World actually is. And I think that's very important. I think that's very important because it is very important to us to kind of understand what Fortnite Save the World actually is. And the fact that this first campaign is wrapping up is really interesting. It feels to me like this is more of a ready game to be presented to the public as a full game, like a full game with future content, DLC, add-ons, whatever you want to call it, downloadable content, with future upgrades and future things coming into the game. So I kind of feel like once this is done, once Save the World, once the Candy Valley storyline is done, it feels to me like Fortnite might be coming out of beta. I really do hope so. I hope that means that Fortnite is going to be coming out of beta and it is going to be presented. Even if it continues to get sold, it will be like, here's the game. Here's Fortnite with an entire story so you can actually play the whole game, finish the story. And if you want to continue playing side quests or more future downloadable content or upgrades or DLC that's going to be coming out, here you go, kind of thing. So I'm really excited for that. I'm honestly very, very excited to see this as a, I don't want to say it's a change, but to see this as a progression in the game. Finally, at this part, they did say something about a final decisive battle against the storm. I think this is fantastic. I think this is incredibly interesting that we are going to have, finally, it seems like we're going to have a final battle. Does this mean that we are going to have a final battle against the storm? Does this mean we're going to have a final battle against, I don't know. I'm kind of very curious to find out what exactly this means for us. You guys know that there has been a long, long time ago, and I can't find it anymore. I've looked for it. A long time ago, there was some images of a giant husk, like a husk the size of a building that was like coming running towards your base. We have mini bosses, we have mist monsters, we have, you know, slightly larger than your average husk enemies that are a little more difficult now with the mini bosses that we have, the progression now with the ones that can pull you together or the volcanic ones and all that. Very interesting and very nice to see, you know, a more rounded out plethora of bosses and mini bosses. And this could be that we're actually going to get to fight a boss. And if it's a final decisive battle against the storm, does this mean that we are finally defeating the storm? If we are defeating the storm and shooing it away, then this means, as like he said in the video, that Fortnite is not a story about survival. It's a story about building a better world. So if we defeat the storm and the storm goes away and we're completely done, then we gotta rebuild. We gotta rebuild after the storm is gone, which honestly opens up such a huge capacity and possibility, because then everyone who has a home base, it could be even more shared. We're all gonna have home bases and we're all trying to help rebuild this world. Building a better world. I think it's awesome. And then finally, to that part, they did finish up saying that they are going to be working for on future content, narrative, and story content for years to come. So it does feel, this is really, really positive for someone like me. I mean, I love this game. I've been following this game for years. For those of you who have been watching me for a while, you know that I started playing this game a couple of weeks before it even was released. I pre-ordered it months way before it came out. I played this game when a lot of people didn't even know what it was, and a lot of people were kind of like, I remember a lot of people thought it wasn't an entertaining game, because at the very beginning it was quite a different game. And it is very exciting to see where it's come. You know, I mean, I've been playing this game for a long time now. I've really been supporting it a lot, and to see where it's going and where it's come from is really, really positive. So I'm very excited to see that. To explain a little bit more about the down tier crafting in Frost Knight, we're going to talk about that really quick. But the Canny Valley Arctic 3, that's something I really want to talk about. But down tier crafting, like I explained at the beginning of this video, basically it means if you have, now there's no reason for me not to take my weapons to 5 stars to max them out. Because the reason why I haven't really done that yet is I don't really have a lot of Sunbeam and whatever the other one is, because I always forget. I have Shadow Shard and Obsidian, so it doesn't matter. Now I can go ahead and level those up, and if I run out of the other materials, if I run out of 5-star materials, it's okay. I can just choose to make 4 stars. Make him Shadow Shard Obsidian. So I like that. I really, really like that. That's really going to help, especially when people get into Canny Valley, because the biggest thing about Canny Valley is you want to rush to get to make those weapons Malachite. You want to rush to make those weapons Shadow Shard. And then you're like, oh, I made a mistake because I don't have any of this material. I've got to grind. I've got to level up to be able to get to the point where I can make them. So that's very positive. I really, really like this. I think it's one of those changes that is really going to bring more of a positivity to the game. But I also do want to note that I do feel that this is going to potentially create a new source of scamming, whereas people are going to be like, hey, here you go, here's a level 130 blah blah, and they're going to quickly switch it out or something and drop something else, because they're going to look the same. The only thing that's going to be different is going to be the number. And you guys know how I feel about trading and scamming. I mean, I don't feel this game was ever designed to be for trading. So I kind of hope that they also continue working towards making, if they want to make an in-game trading system, great. But you know what? We'll see that. And finally, Frost Knight. So Frost Knight is pretty much, from what I saw, just from what I saw in the video, the little snippet I saw, it very much looks like, it looks pretty much exactly like the winter event, the Christmas, well, let's call it the winter event, the winter event we had last year. Just looking at it, the map looked very similar. Basically, it was defend the siphon kind of thing, where you got dropped into like a winter map and you had to progressively build, and you had to set up siphons or blue glow siphons or something like that, and then you had to defend them against progressively bigger and harder waves. You couldn't really farm up materials, you only had to get a certain amount, and that was pretty much it. That was kind of how it was. So I guess it was kind of like a survive the storm kind of event. I don't exactly remember. I'm going to have to go back and check my previous videos for it, because I do remember that I did do quite a few streams and videos about that event last year. It kind of seems like the same thing to me. I don't, for an event like that, I got it to be honest, I don't expect or necessarily want to see a story connected to it. Now, it's fine if you know you have like a progressive kind of like event where, you know, complete this many or do this many or do x amount of things in a mission or in a new map to be able to get tickets or gold. Definitely gold. Oh, man, we need that. So I don't mind that, but even if they just, you know, copy paste last year's event, I'm sure, you know, they'll bring back the same, well, not the same, but we had banners and heroes as rewards last time, so hopefully, you know, hopefully it becomes like that. I do really hope, and this is something that I'm going to finish off by saying this, I really, really, really hope that the cram session, I would love to see cram sessions at the end of an event, like the last week or 2 weeks of an event, because that's when you were all rushing to get the gold. There's a bunch of stuff still in the event shop. You need a ton of gold for those things. A bunch of gold at the beginning of an event is nice, but it's not as needed as if you just do like, if you do like mini events, mini cram session events, like scattered along the version, I think would be much better. But anyway, I'm gonna leave it there, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Here we go, guys. Developer update. I think it was a fantastic one. Very surprised to see Canny Valley Act 3 already, but like I said, I do believe that it was already scheduled for version 7. We just got part 2 a little later. Down tier crafting looks amazing, and Frost Knight. So hopefully we're also going to see a series of new weapons with a new ticket and a new llama. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. As always, I am DUJ2. I hope you guys have a fantastic day. Thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you guys next time. See ya.